one more speaker. This is Von Clayton. He is ready for state party chair and former chairman of CD2 and judicial chair of some sort. So, Von Clayton.
Thank you, Pat. Thank you for inviting me here, for inviting all of us candidates for state party chair. I have been active for the last 17 years, well, since 1995, in the judicial election movement of the Republican Party in Minnesota. And since 2002, all of the 10 judicial districts in Minnesota have been organized. Here's Bob Tatro and Dave Schumacher, the leaders of Judicial District 10. We have active groups in every judicial district, and we are working, as you might know, you've been getting my emails, I think, to defeat the Cui Amendment in the state legislature, which would take away your right to vote for judges. Now, this is a serious problem. This is because the Democrats are generally in favor of it, and a few Republicans are signed on. They could push it over the top. So you need to talk to people like Tim Sanders and other people you know, Julie Rosen, Dave Senjum in the Senate. Dave Thompson, by the way, took his name off on Thursday. So please call him and thank him. Joe Hoppe also is taking his name off. He hasn't done it yet, but he's promised to do it. So our work, your work, is working. I also want to tell you about the state party race. I think these are not disconnected, but let me tell you that the party is bankrupt. Not technically, of course, but we've had to work out arrangements with our creditors, and we have to find some way to figure out how to raise more money. We haven't been able to do it for the last year. It's been tough. The big givers don't want to give to us because they don't want to pay for our debt. Well, the big givers are going to be giving less and less as time goes on because of Citizens United. Maybe you're familiar with that case. They're inclined now more to give the super PAC. And that's a centralized kind of fundraising anyway. It gives us lots of money at the state party level, but nothing in the BPOUs and the CDs. Another kind of centralized fundraising that we've been dependent on is phone bank fundraising, professional, and direct mail. That's also never going to be as good as it was because PCR is gone. So this is a problem. Now what are we going to do? Okay, so people that have been around for more than 10 years remember hearing about Century and Neighbor to Neighbor. This is volunteer fundraising. This is what we need to do. When we raise money that way, and we raise millions of dollars every year with that program in the 60s and the 70s and the early 80s, we can do it again. Basically what we do is the BPOUs raise money from from their members, $100 for a dinner, $125 for a couple, come and hear a major speaker, like Ronald Reagan came to speak to us, Spiro Agnew came when he was vice president. We can get big speakers for this kind of thing, raise a lot of money. And then the big givers will start giving us a little bit more. I've been active in the party for many years. I've been congressional district chair four times, CD3 chair, CD2 chair, the old CD2 I was chair of 30 years ago. I've been BPOU chair, active in the BPOU, holding many other offices. The other candidates have not. Keith Downey and Bill Paulson have not held offices even in their BPOU. So let me tell you then about the June primary. Keith Downey supports that. I am dead set against it. If we go to a June primary, we will defeat and we will destroy our endorsing process because there won't be enough time between endorsing and June primary for our endorsed candidates to get traction. That's essential. So what will happen is that people with money will file, run against our endorsed candidates, and win. This is not good for our endorsement process. So let me just summarize and say that I've got the experience in the party. I know how to raise money and get rid of our debt. I'm opposed to the June primary, and I'm in favor of promoting legislators who will follow the platform. Thank you.
Thank you.